Let's finish this one off. We'll do quiet sprint. Okay. Cool. So we did that. We did that quest. Let's teleport to way the fuck over here. Actually, are there any collectibles we haven't grabbed in this vicinity? I want to filter this map, to be totally honest.
Welcome to the math squad.
Bong Solo 88. Oh my god, I've got a Jesus I'd like to introduce you to. Bong Solo 88. Please make yourself friends with Boxcart Jesus 420. Alright, we'll just go explore. We'll go get this flower. We'll do a little of that first. Also, that was a great quest, and Petra is hot as fuck. I gotta, sell some of this stuff. Hey, Steak Mittens. Yeah, it's always cool meeting Math Squad folks at PAX. It makes me happy. See, that kind of stuff is a good way to introduce like gay content into your games, just by having people express their gayness in a way that isn't like, ah, this character is gay, look at them with their rainbow armor and their fucking homosexual agenda. Like, just being like, look, this is Petra, you're a woman, she's a woman, she's into you, she's flirting with you. It doesn't have to be a big fucking thing, but it's real. It's like a real thing, it's in the game, there are characters who hit on you, and they are of a variety of genders, and that's like, just it is what it is. And that is, that's fucking great. That is some good shit. I'm about it. I mean, if you want to have, you know, rainbow armor and the gay agenda, yes, I'm into it. Actually, that's the name of my new band. Rainbow Armor and the Gay Agenda. Whoa, this can be a good photo when I get up here. Look at this snowy peaks. Yeah, I mean, don't downplay the gay, but like, keep in mind that the gayness is like a factor in the character. It's just a part of who they are. Here we go. Bum bum. Bum 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 bum. Let's get that field of view. Schwam. And let's get rid of Aloy. Sorry, Aloy. You're just not that cool to look at. And then let's fuck with the time of day. Make that shit more cinematic. Dawn over the boring valley. Let's get some better sunlight. Yeah, here we go. I'm not feeling it. It's just nothing really to look at here. I'm out. Sometimes you think there's gonna be a photo and there just isn't.
To the math squad.
What's up, Mythic Blue Hill? Welcome. Welcome to the squad. This is kind of a cool little valley. Oh man, is that two of the Tyrannosaurus dudes? Oh shit. Yeah, I think including non-straight NPCs is tricky, because often the only way to know whether they are straight or not is to engage their their sexuality. And in a game where that's just not really a thing, that can be tricky, and those characters can be invisible. And I think this game is doing a great job because it's not about relationships, but like, Aloy's a cutie. The game recognizes that. The world knows that she's a cute babe, and like, it's a thing. And that's great. I love that. I think that's really neat. And it doesn't make it a core element of the gameplay or anything, and it doesn't have to, but like, you know, Petra is like, no, you're a cute person, and I wanna
use out here.
Tell you that, and then maybe you'll smooch me. So the deal with fighting these things is we blow off their guns. For fuck's sake. And then we pick them up and we fuck them up with them. Now, I don't have any of the things that I really need to, like, mess this guy up. So I can freeze her. Alright, where are you dropping your guns at? Can I fight two Tyrannosauruses at once? Chances are, maybe. These bombs do hella damage, so. Worst case scenario, I can use those. Oh, Jesus. I just got blown off the screen. Like, just completely off screen. Yikes. That was something. Wow. Okay. Sure. Thanks for that. So anyway, let's try that shit again. Oh, I'm all the way back here. God damn it. Alright. I gotta redo my skills. I gotta save on my way over there. Maybe overriding one of the lesser creatures. Now what I want to do is kill those two Tyrannosauruses. I've set a quest for myself. And I definitely need to buy more wire. Can I buy that wire in bulk, dude? Can you just, like, Costco that shit for me? Because that's what I want to do. Like, just bulk purchase, please. Give me the fucking... Come on. Just give me the damn thing. Hey, Crystal Lynx. I just need a Costco-sized fucking tub of wires. I've got the membership card. I scavenged one. Fine, fucking jerk-offs. I'll buy them one at a time. All right, Operation Dino Kill is a go. I'll try not to use my precision arrows for now. Oh, Jesus, Tim. 300, one at a time. Yeah, why can't I just buy a bunch? Game? Come on. I thought you liked me. I thought we were friends. You know what I like about Costco? The hot dogs. The big... Do all Costcos have those hot dogs? Is that a thing? Hey, still pristine. Welcome back. Oh yeah, that's great, Trist. Yeah, a hardhold set in a Costco, yeah, and like the membership cards are how you know whether you're part of the hold or not. And there's like a limited number of them, or you could get them from like another town. Yeah, Costco hot dogs, and they're cheap as fuck too. They're like $2. Yeah, that's right. Are you gonna give me your fucking fox?
Oh, well, already.
Oh shit, I think that might be the skin that I need. Let me drop something useless, like this pile of things. Oh my god, Blaze. Just Blaze?
Remix. Pew.
Anyway, let's go back to talking about those Costco hot dogs. No, let's not do that. Okay, birds, stop fucking up my shit. Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm not talking shit about Just Blaze. I'm all about it. Alright, Operation Double Dino. We're doing it. What are the name of the characters from Double Dragon? Like Tommy and Billy or something? All I remember is Abobo, the first boss. And you kick him off the escalator thing. Alright, here we go.
Red light means trouble.
Okay, and then freeze arrows. So this time I can probably actually get that. Big boy. Time to die.
Yes! Fucking awesome.
Alright, that's one. One down. I like how it just notified every monster in the whole fucking area. Dealing like 2,000. done like dinner. I can fight two Tyrannosauruses, and it feels so good. Bam. Look at that. All right, let's go look at what mods I just got. Inventory mods. Look at them all. Some heavy tear coils. I can start selling some of these. Some fire coils, which are sort of whatever. A lot of fire. Fire and shock right now. Ooh, freeze. That might be better than what I have now. Let's take a look at my weapons. So, this one has... The sharp shot mostly has tear and damage.
Our illustrious champion.
Do I have anything better than 41?
Welcome home.
Yeah, let's clear these tear and put the two best tear ones in. 40 and 40. This one's tear and damage though, so let's put that one in. Tartarus, welcome back. And then the Lodge Warbow I've got, yeah, freeze, tear, shock, and freeze. This corruption one, I think I'm gonna pop out and replace with another freeze, because I mostly use this bow for freezing anyway. And then this is all damage for the big bombs. And then this is all handling. Now, do I have anything better for handling? Because this one is 6 and 6. Oh, I could throw another tear. Yeah. I mean, this thing doesn't really do tear, though, so... Here we go. 37%. That's much faster. This is gonna be the fastest freaking gun ever. That's awesome. Okay. We did it. Now I gotta go back and find that flower, which I know is around here. I saw it. I just didn't... I didn't grab it. It'd be really cool if I could, add, there it is. If I could add a, note to the map, because this is a great place for farming those T-Rexes, like two at once.
I made these flowers.
That's awesome. Okay, let's see what other things are on the map. Where else can I go? Oh, good, it already has a Thunderjaw site. Okay, cool. So it'll just mark that for me. And then if I ever need Thunderjaws, remind me if I need to, like, grind for mods. This little valley, and here's the shit. Okay. Yeah, let's go do this guy. Let's go do this site. Okay. Now I'm just a humble T-Rex robot farmer. Is that another robot over there, T-Rex? Yeah, it is. All right, I'll let that one move. I'm a merciful god. Here in T-Rex Valley.
Easier when I was a kid.
Oh yeah, can I get through this? Oh, whatever, I'm already at the far end. Yeah, the waypoints do tend to prioritize roads, but that's okay. I want to clear. I can come up and clear this area anyway. Lighting is pretty cool, how it just cuts off right on the edge like that. I like that. The cart-edged mountain. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Oops. So we're going this way. Okay, and then we can grab this thing, and that'll help clear out some of this territory, and then maybe go up and get these flowers. Yeah, okay. And next time I'm at a merchant, someone try to remind me that I can, I think I can buy that permanent fast travel kit now, which is hella good.
another signal. The killers. What are they doing here?
They're looking for Mr. Brightside, obviously. There's an early 2000s indie rock joke for you. You like that? You like that, everybody? Yeah.
I must be closing in on the signal. I need to find a way up to the tall neck's head.
Right in the ear.
It looks like they're trying to capture the tall neck.
Don't capture the tall neck. What's the highest point? Jerk. Little big guy. Okay, I'll go around this way and try to meet it. Fuck. Oh, hi. Surprise! Okay. Do I ascend to this structure?
What the blazes was that?
I like how you do have an opportunity to silent strike them as soon as they see you. Okay, I don't have time to do this. How do I get up? Bye. Alright, let's do... I'll do some crafting. That'll help eat up some of the resources that I have. Because my resource satchel is full, so if I... bunch of ropes and shit. That should help that out. And then I also need to craft potions. Okay. Can I pick this thing up? Do I have an empty slot? I do. Noodled. You want one? I got a present for you. It's called... the grave.
Oh,
hi.
What?
Shit, sorry. Oh. Listen, I just... oh. This is awkward. Oh. Christ. Okay, we're gonna switch to the big guns. Yeah, look, I can do that too. Hey, where's your heavy weapon now, sucker? Deathbringer gun. Yeah, sorry, it's gonna do that thing again where I use a heavy weapon and it's loud. I do apologize.
Always said, patience.
This gun is so insane. This gun sucks. Welcome back, Kage. Another thing I can't climb up. He's really fucking with me on this. Hi. Yep. Okay, well, I guess we're just around here. Yeah, the giant giraffe is what I'm is why I'm here in the first place. I didn't mean to fight these guys. Well, I mean, they're bad. So, you know. Here we go. Okay.
I think I can move on to the tonic.
So we can just hang out up here. And ice these fools. Do they just forget about me? Well, it turns out that I, like Dre, am not to be forgotten.
Quietly.
Okay, there we go. So there should be a... be a guy that I can... Come on, just hurry up. Come on by. I've killed basically all the banditos, so I got nothing else to do.
This should be a good spot for jumping onto the tonic.
Yeah. Come on by. So what the tall neck will do is it'll reveal a bunch of area, which will make hunting for random objects much easier. Also, I'm only 12 levels away from max level. Yeah, NPCs in games like this must be horrified of the wind. They're always talking about how, like, oh, it must be the wind that murdered all of our friends.
Now to climb up to its head.
It's cool, hey? Oops, no. I want to take a photo, not load. All right, let's see what the time of day looks like. There we go. Yeah, climb that giraffe. I love the sound it makes. The radar ping. Tell me everything. Again, it's really too bad that Aloy is such a featureless goob. Like, look at her. Aloy, you're standing on the back of a cool electro giraffe, and that's the best face you can make? T- like do something. Stop wiggling. Make a face.
Ah, oh, fuck!
Oh boy. Okay, well, that worked. That the guy. Okay, well, sure. Fine. Let's see what the next thing we can go get is. Oh, that was pretty good. I feel pretty good about that. Let's get this flower. Oh my god. He asked me to make a face, so I died. Alright, what's the closest? I guess this one. old corpse face. Old corpse face McGee. Right. I'll grab this herb and then I'll turn around. Ooh, that's an ominous sun. Oh my god, Ferrisar. Aloy has resting corpse face. Yeah, Pig, you better run. Ooh, look. Look at that cool stone archway. That's pretty cool. Go look at it. Neat. I wonder if I could like line up a shot with all those little things in it. Hi.
Should have brought a cart.
Yeah, I definitely should have. I need to sell some of these dumb resources. This could be a cool photo. Let's mess around with it a little. Nope. Drink. That's kind of cool. Time of day will make or break this photo, I think. So let's see what we can get. It's kind of cool. I think I need to increase the... Let's get the front of this rock in focus and then increase the aperture. There we go. Yeah, that's like, it's pretty good, actually. I'm pretty into that. Okay, let's take a look at time of day and see if maybe there's a better... So we can get them all like red, or we can do, oh yeah, look at that. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I'm pretty about that. Okay, here, let's. That's a pretty good shot. I'm pretty into it. No, why did I do that? God damn it. I hate that. Ugh. Stupid Adam, press the wrong button. Cause you have to go share then triangle, and I forgot and I hit triangle instead. I suck. I'm a bad photographer. All right, what do we say? F8, I think. Focal distance. About there. Is that a little more? Yeah, here we go. Okay. And then it was brightness up. Time of day. Here we go. Okay. We fixed it. I'm not totally terrible. Okay, I actually think I want to mess with the depth of field a little more. It's not as sharp as it could be on those rocks. Yeah, see? I just don't want that back rock as in focus. So this is where in a regular camera, or in the camera that I use anyway, there'd be like a focus assist where the area in focus would blink red. To let me know whether it's like my eyes being blurry or whether it's, cause sometimes that happens, right? Like, you know, you stare at a thing long enough without blinking and you lose a little bit of your ability to perceive whether something's actually sharp or not. There we go. Okay. Color balance on that, I think. So yeah, like a focus assist, even on a manual focus lens, can be really helpful. Because then you can tell if you are fucking it up or not. Pack of grumblers. So welcome to the enchanted swamp. Look at that. It's pretty cool. Interesting how in black and white you can kind of like, you can actually see the moon or the mountains, I guess. It's kind of cool. Yeah, I like that. Again, good palette. Neat stone bridge forms and stuff in this area, and more obviously more awesome Skyrim climbing. So, okay, anywhere in this area, we're looking for flowers, hidden flowers. There we go. All right, what's next? I guess there's a Bannock figure there. We could go do, and there's also a bunch of other like actual quest shit out this way. Right, meet errand, metal flowers, vantage points. Let's try to make sure we've cleared this junk first. Alexander? Yeah, I definitely would. I mean, if you're into like open world exploration, if you're into beautiful looking world stuff, then yeah, definitely worth a play, I would say. I'm having as much fun just shooting pictures of stuff, because that's something that I like really, really love in real life. As I am anything else. I made a post the other day about how if I ever like won the lottery, I would. Oh, hey Deb. How you doing? If I ever won the lottery, I would just spend a ton of money on like camera equipment, and I would wander the world taking photos of things. And it would be beautiful. I'll do it when I'm old. I'm gonna save up my money, and when I'm an old ass man, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna be like Gandalf, only with a camera. Camdolf. But not Webcamdolf. Yeah, I think what I'm really curious about, to your point, Farisar, about like this and like open world games in general, I'm real curious about how I'm gonna feel about Zelda when I play it. And how this game, like if I go, so what I think is gonna end up happening, because how long do we have before Persona? Like a month? Like, I feel like I'm just gonna play this till Persona comes out, because I'm taking such a fucking long time to get through it. Not that that's a problem, just that I wonder if we're gonna have it done by then. We must, right? Yeah, I'm gonna have to save, Zelda, and I'm gonna have to save, it's funny because my Switch is just in a box, like, sitting next to my computer, and I want to play it, but, like, that RPG content, though.
You have returned.
What's up, Suzerel? How am I supposed to get to this? Yeah, exactly. My schedule is real packed with RPG stuff, so video games kind of don't... They don't get as much play. I think I have to go around. I think this is not the correct way. Let's slide down here. He said, trying to Skyrim his way to the objective. There we go. So yeah, I think what'll end up happening is I'll just play this and then, yeah, beast through the story. Yeah, good point, Trust. And then we'll just play. Persona when it comes out. Oh, Jesus. Bye. Bye-bye, birdie. Persona, though, that game. It's gonna be a long one too, but that's okay. That's what we like. We like exploratory biz. Okay, so I'm finally actually in the Bannock area. I think I came at it from the wrong side, so.
Another Bannock figurine.
Yeah, see? We're almost done. We only need two more. That's significant. Alright, let's go. Where's the next reasonable... Oh, there's a vantage up here. Okay, let's go do that one. I really need a merchant. That's what I need. I need a goddamn merchant. I know, right, Minigun? Like, it's been an insane few months, and it's not gonna stop, either. Like, we're just gonna keep getting more and more and more, like, games. Maybe I should... Yeah, I'm gonna hit this merchant first. I should've done that instead. Yeah, we're just gonna keep getting good games, and then hopefully that'll just carry us through the... That'll carry us through the cold period, right? When there isn't as much to play. But yeah, wow. I saw Bike Man posted just a kind of teaser picture he found on the internet of someone playing a Monster Hunter game on the Switch. Ooh, man, that's gonna be fun. God, I've lost so many hours just playing Monhu. Like, it's the kind of game that I will just be like, it's like Civ for me. Monhu is like Civ, where I'll be like, I'm gonna play one. See you, Narwhal. See you. I'm gonna play one more. I'm gonna do one more hunt. Okay, one more hunt. One more hunt. It's cool. I'll do another one. It's fine. Yeah. Just one more. Okay, cool. Golden fast travel pack. There we go. Unlimited fast travel. We did it, kid. So now I can sell all my fast travel shit. But yeah, Monhu is going to be a game that I play a bunch of when they release one for the Switch because I really like that stuff. It's a fun game. And yeah, I would be super into like a real dry summer as far as games go. Because... I mean, I've got stuff to go back to. Like, we still haven't played Neo. I want to play Neo real bad. I bought it. plus, like, the Kingdom Hearts is getting the PS4 like update remake thing. Yeah, there's just so much amazing shit to play. It makes me really happy, but it also is. Yeah, right. Andromeda's coming out. I could make a list of just games between now and, like, June. That I want to play, and that would take up a ton of time. It's fun. I'm really excited about it. Mass Effect's going to be a great one for the channel, because it's a game where I can actually flirt with everybody and everything. And I guarantee you, I swear to God, I am going to bang the living shit out of as many aliens as I possibly can. Yeah. That is my goal. That's my goal for that game. I gotta figure out what kind of character I want to play though, because normally, when I play Mass Effect, Shepard, my Shepard, is like a tough, like Vasquez kind of character, like a sort of a butch. Lesbian with a alien fetish. So I gotta figure out a new. What's the name of that character in Andromeda? But yeah, I gotta figure it out. Maybe we'll do a dude this time. We'll see. We'll see what the voice acting, what people think the best voice acting is. Ryder, that's right, that's the character's name. Oh yeah.
Come on.
That white haired girl, she's pretty hot looking, but she's not an alien, she's a human, right? So we'll see. I can't pre-bang all the characters. We gotta let them stand on their own merits. Yeah.
They're scanning for me.
I'm gonna name my can you make your character's first name? Because if you can, I'm gonna name her Rough Rider. Because you know I have to. I'm contractually obligated by rap music. Yeah, let's make this one black and white. You can? All right, perfect. Her name is going to be Rough Rider. She will have her own anthem. And I will instruct everyone to listen to it before the stream. What time of day control is unavailable? When has that ever been true? Well, I guess I gotta make do like a regular old photographer. I kind of want to see what the other black and white looks like. Yeah, that's pretty good. Pretty into that. Yeah, her name would be spelled R-U-F-F Rider. Maybe I'll just make my character DMX and I'll bark at all the NPCs. I don't know if I could sustain an entire playthrough that way, though. Alright, we gotta keep going. Oh, I gotta climb up. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Just channel Cantor Hague. Yeah, it's gonna be a good way to get my ass killed. This is cool. Is this like a building? Crashed spaceship, maybe? Oh, this is a vantage. We're gonna get to see what this is real quick, actually. Shit. Dope climbing skills, girl.
Stalkers, watchers, what are they doing all the way up here?
What are you doing all the way up here? More to the point, Aloy. Turkeys, what are they doing all the way up here? Whoa, that's a lot of mines. Okay, so that's Jesus. Okay, this ought to be fun. A little gauntlet. Stalker gauntlet. Try to get through, get here stealthily. I wonder, I've never used these corruption arrows. But basically they cause them to like attack each other, right? So the medicinal herbs are just straight up opium poppies. Shit. Shit again. Fire! Okay, so, holy crap. Ooh, those are scary. Oh, get away from me. I gotta throw a rock in the water. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, scary invisible stalkers. They're a thing. They're definitely a thing. All right. Oh, okay. So this is just this like little valley I need to sneak through. All right. I thought it was here, but it's not. I just need to move.
Let's get on with it.
I just need to get through this area. Oh yeah, my sprint is silent now. So let's go, like, just run. Oh god, this makes me cold just looking at it.
I think I'm in the clear.
Look at how free. Oh god. Can you imagine trying to hold on to this fucking rock with the cold wind and. Jesus, Aloy, you are too cool, honey. An Altair look like a chump.
Territorial here, but what am I intruding on?
Oh yeah, we gotta take our sad journey photo. Not the band, the game. Yeah. Watch the time of day thing won't make any difference. Oh, I can't. Okay, never mind. It definitely won't make any difference now. No, I kind of like it just as none. Debt rule of thirds, though. Rad. Jesus, what is up with this area? Yeah, good eye for us. The snowflakes are actually 3D, right? Like if we look at them, they're physical objects. They're tiny, but they're not just two dimensional. They have shape. See, there's one. Isn't that cool?